foreman, Hasavat, were so funny that the other workers would stop working to laugh at them, which infuriated the Sultan, who had both men executed. The story of Karagöz gave birth to the shadow theater of Bursa. Like every morning in his father Sinazi's tiny shop, İbrahim Koka gets together with Uğur Selikol to improvise and rehearse the camel skin puppet show they will present in October during the big shadow theater festival in Bursa.
Çok çok çok. Oo Acımat, ben de seni çok severim. İkimiz çok iyi arkadaşız ya. Karagöz'üm bak, haftaya sünnet düğününe gideceğiz. Oo Acımat çok güzel ya. Ben de çok seviyorum sünnetini. Karagöz'üm sen sünnet oldun mu? Hayır olmadım ben. Karagöz'üm niye olmadı? Şimdi seni sünnet yapalım ya. Oo Acımat çabuk çabuk çabuk çabuk.
Vay Karagöz'üm. Akşam-ı şerifler hayırlar olsun. Akşam-ı şeriflerin hayırlar olsun. Ol şu tokadın suratına.
Olur. Aman birader nedir bu işler? Kafada patlasın kış işler. Hoş olsun Gülhane, yıktın perdeyi, eğledin viran.
Far to the south, Nike's silhouette greets the visitor from the site of Ephesus, where archaeological digs continue. The origins of the city of Ephesus go back more than 4,000 years, when nomads settled by the sea to build a temple to honor the mother goddess Cybele, goddess of fertility. Since then, Ephesus has seen different civilizations. Cybele gave way to the Greek goddess Artemis, or Diana as she is also known, goddess of maternity, fecundity, and fertility. Countless others continued the line, all the way to the Virgin Mary herself. Successive beliefs and cultures crossed paths in Ephesus, the majestic, flourishing city of antiquity where tradesmen from all over the world did business. The city's cultivated prestige was strained resisting the ever-conquering hordes from across the sea. Like wave upon wave they came, jealous of her beauty. And so it was. The port slowly filling with successive illusions, forcing Ephesus into the ground, to a destiny over which would march the successive armies of Croesus, and then Hetstati, and then Alexander the Great himself, and finally the Goths, until, tired by the centuries, but still wearing her most beautiful diadems, Ephesus fell and was abandoned in the swamps of history. Even the faraway Temple of Artemis, seventh wonder of the world, would disappear. But where other historical sites of antiquity were washed away forever by the sea, Ephesus was first swallowed up by the ground. So Ephesus, the too beautiful, the too ideal, was preserved in the ground when the sea pulled away to flow to other shores. And today, as Ephesus is unburied, antiquity's story, mutilated by the ages, is written on its marble remains. What is left of Ephesus? Gladiators fixed in eternity. Stone-etched images of screaming, greedy spectators seeking guilty sensation. A time when lions and gladiators and weapons were daily fare, and not merely evocations of well-turned tales. On a hot summer night 2,000 years later, spectators might come to the old theater of Ephesus. It is said that the goddess Artemis had the same hopes for humanity as the Virgin Mary. Every morning, Not far from Ephesus, Father Miriam opens the doors of a house unlike all others.